I'm going on a cruise. What's up, Money Geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in today's video, I'm going to take a look at another cruise company. So we're going to take a look at NCLH, Norwegian Cruise. We're going to examine the stock and just see where they are and see if it's a buy or it's a hold or a sell. But before we jump into the details, guys, if you're new to the channel, we talk about how to earn money, how to save money, and how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that really interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. So yesterday, the CEO of Norwegian Cruise, again, ticker symbol NCLH, appeared on Jim Cramer and made some really interesting facts. So let's examine the stock throughout this process. Again, I'm talking about a cruise here, cruise company, because we all know they are completely grounded. Things are not working. People don't want to go on cruises because it's kind of confined environment. They worry about the spread of the virus. So as far as business, a lot of these companies are really, really hurting. So it's a great opportunity for you to take advantage of the situation. So let's examine Norwegian Cruise. Prior to the virus, I think in January of 2020, their 52-week high was about $59 a share. And then come the virus in March, the stock dropped down to around $8. So 52-week low to about $8 a share. And as of right now that I'm making this video, they were trending around $12 a share. Which is obvious. I mean, people are not taking any cruises. Nobody wants to get on the cruise because it's scary. You don't want to get sick. And when you get sick, most people got trapped on the cruise ship and they don't even let you get to mainland, which is kind of scary. So why would somebody want to do that? Again, just some facts. If you remember, I think it was CCL, that's Carnival Cruise. When this virus kind of broke out, they had some people on the ship and they were sick. And so they were trapped on the actual cruise ship. They wouldn't even let them out of the ship until they did some tests. And they went through the 14 days incubation period before some people were let out. So a lot of people got scared. But Norwegian Cruise didn't experience that. They were good. All their ships came and just people were able to get off the ships. But here's what I want you to take a look at. So the CEO, again, appeared on Jim Cramer and said they have actually raised $2 billion during this period, which is good enough to keep them afloat from now to up to about 18 months, which is crazy. I mean, you're thinking like companies are bleeding cash right now and they are able to raise $2 billion to keep them afloat. That tells me they're doing something right. So this is at $12 a share. This is really, really enticing. I mean, I'm drooling over this stock right now. But the one thing you need to know is they haven't declared any dividends or whatsoever. So if you're buying into Norwegian Cruise, know that two things. You're buying for long term, hoping that, you know, when things get back, you get some growth. There's no dividend. So you might just buy when, you know, when they recover, you sell and move on if you are a dividend investor. Again, another thing that he mentioned on the call with Jim Cramer was that they plan to sell in 2020. He didn't give a specific date and he said, I don't want to give a specific date, but our goal is our ships are ready to go in 2020. Estimate is looking like, hey, sometime in July or August, that's when they think about getting the ships back in the ocean. One thing that really resonated was the fact that he mentioned that they are actually selling a ton of tickets right now. And so I'm like, huh, how are people buying tickets to go on a cruise right now? I don't know, but he says a lot of their customers are taking advantage of this period and buying tickets, just getting ready so that when they say it's time to sail, they would actually jump out and go sailing. So my personal observation, or the way I would approach this particular stock, is this stock is really, really undervalued. Hearing that they were able to raise $2 billion in capital to keep them afloat for at least another 18 months, even if they don't operate, they have enough money to keep them afloat. That gives me a lot of confidence. The fact that he thinks the ships are ready to sail sometime this year, and they're not being investigated in any shape or form. So there's some positive news there. On the flip side, the fear aspect is that we don't know how people are going to adjust to this. This is a new phenomenon. He thinks people are going to jump on the ship and go. People are buying tickets. So is that going to work exactly as planned? We have no idea. So it's kind of a risky stock. But if you do have a little bit of change, a little bit of capital that you think you want some growth at $12 a share, again, pending any news that comes out, the stock might be something that you can put some money in there, hope that it goes up and then you can sell it and get out of it. So again, put money that you think you can hang on for a little bit, because all from Carnival Cruise to Royal Caribbean to Norwegian Cruise, all these cruise lines are gonna really, really be one of the last industry to actually recover and get back to normal. So yeah, go in there with the intention of like, hey, going for a long ride. It's gonna slowly walk its way up, and that's the only way that you can see maybe some really good growth. Question of the day: what do you think about a Norwegian Cruise? I mean, they have raised $2 billion to keep them afloat for 18 months. They plan on getting back into the ocean as soon as September. And then they also believe that their customers are actually buying a lot of tickets and getting ready to get back in the ocean. What do you think? You think it's a good buy? You think it sucks? Like, stay away from cruises? Let me know in the comment section. And as always, guys, like, share, subscribe. YouTube tells me that 90% of you guys watching haven't already subscribed to my channel. So if you can do me the favor, hit the subscribe button and give a thumbs up to the video if you like it. And as always, stay motivated.